2022 spring track and field season for the Kinnelon Colts was one to remember. It was full of triumphs and trials, heartbreaks and heroics, and every other emotion that life could throw our way. The Colts came in with big goals, including repeating as county relay champions and conference champions. The Colts wanted to finish the triple crown of North 1 Group 1 sectional championships that had started in cross country and continued through indoor track. They even wanted to make a run at a state title. That's all to come. The season starts, as every season does, right here on this track with the dual meets.
Dual meets are a good way to get back into the season. I think it's also a good way to bond with the underclassmen, you know, get them back, you know, get them starting meets. You know, they haven't really had a meet experience in high school, and I think it's a good team bonding experience to jump back right back into track season.
We're here with Eli Gately. Name, grade, event group.
I think you said it already, but I'm Eli Gately, and I'm a distance runner for Kinnelon Track and Cross Country. I think dual meets are really fun because, you know, you're not competing with the top guys in the state, but I think it's a really fun way to just, you know, get back into running.
Ion Raza.
Grade and event group.
I'm a senior, and my event group is distance. What dual meets bring that other opportunities in the season don't bring is to experiment, to try new things. You know, if you're a distance runner, per se, right? But you know that you want to try maybe throws or jumps, you have that opportunity. And the dual meets give you an opportunity to see where you are in the season, right? So it gives you a good starting point, and it just gives you an opportunity to just have fun and just try out the sport.
Living the good life full of goodbyes. My eyes are on the gray sky, saying I don't wanna come home tonight. Yeah, and I'm higher up off wood. I don't even remember, but my friend passed out in the override. Oh, I'm from the city of the 915, where all the girls are pretty and they're down for the hype. All my boys are with me going up for the night. But who cares? Who cares? This is all you. So wake me up in the spring while I'm high off my American dream. We don't always say what we. I've been waiting all year to get the hell up out of here and throw away my fears. I'm so faded, I'm so faded off of all the things that I've taken. Maybe I'm not really drunk, maybe I'm really good at faking. From the city of the 915, where all the girls are pretty and they're down for the hype. And all my boys are with me going up for the night. Who cares, who cares, 'cause this is all you. So wake me up in the
spring. Thoughts for today?
Ranking 5, longer line, something like it.
We don't always say what we mean. It's the lie of an American dream. My youth is the foundation of me. Living life as an American team. American team. Mm, oh yeah. We don't always say what we mean when we're high off our American team. My youth is the foundation of me. Oh, I'm proud to be American. So wake me up in the spring while I'm half my American. And we don't always say what we mean. It's the lie American chain, American chain. Oh, yeah. American teenager. I'll be living this dream with you.
Finished the dual meet season with a 3-1 record. The goal was to win all our dual meets, but an unfortunate scheduling conflict the week of the Whippany Park meet meant we weren't at full strength for that meet, and we took an unfortunate loss. However, the dual meet season was highlighted by a number of important victories, with significant wins coming over Booton, Morris Catholic, and Pequannock. This showed the strength of our team from the top to the bottom throughout all event groups. How would you say the dual meets went for you?
It was Booton, I ran the 1 and 2, and those went well. I lost to Clyde both times, but that's all right. I'm Jack Ahart, I'm a junior, and I'm a sprinter. They were fine. I didn't run much in the dual meets because the first one against Pequannock, I think I only ran the 100. And then I didn't run in Whippany because I was on vacation. And then I didn't run against Morris Catholic because I was being punished for being on vacation. So, but other than that, I mean, it went pretty well. Like, it was good. Yeah.
After a very positive start to the season through the dual meets, the next part of the schedule brought along relays. So now we head to Randolph.
Told me, son, you could be anything, long as you spread your wings. I know one day you'll be great, just wait, soon you'll aim up at the sky, and I'll watch it float away. But now that I am older, I'll admit that I am over all the stress and shit that comes from holding life upon your shoulders. It's a chore, I'm sick of being bored, I'm sick of always stressing over shit I could ignore. I guess it's just my own immaturity burning through me internally. Take imagination and making it a reality. So pause, yo, fuck it, I'll be right back. Pay a visit to the past, tell them all to kiss my ass for a second. I don't wanna worry about loving for a while. I just wanna play around, live it like a child with old tunes jamming on my Walkman and some Sour Patch Kids and a Coke can. Prince, cartoons, good raps, dope tracks, and I'm not trying to be on it, I'm just trying to be honest. Packed lunch, school crush, bus home and play Sonic. I have been there, I have done that, made my mark up on the town. Been stupid, I've been lucid, been a menace and a clown. Wow, I'm chilling, watching Rocko's Modern Living, wishing I could find a way to bring back music television. No more Jersey Shore and horror or horribly boring versions of shows from Great Britain. They're written with no vision, yo, damn. So fuck it, I'll be right back. Pay my tribute to the past. You can all just kiss my ass for a second. I don't wanna worry about nothing for a while. I just wanna play around, live it like a child with old tunes jamming on my Walkman and some Sour Patch Kids and a Coke can.
And what is your least favorite event?
The 3200.
Oh. Okay, so we're here with Ready? And what school do you go to?
Go.
And what is your least favorite event?
3200.
Yes.
Yeah.
What's your name? I'll be on. And what school do you go to?
Kinnelon High School.
And what's your least favorite event?
800.
Sour Patch Kids and a Coke can. Yeah. I don't wanna worry about nothing for a while. I just wanna play around, living like a child with old tunes jamming on my Walkman.
After a fun and exciting start to the season, we now look forward to championship season. With events battled out at the conference level, county level, and state level, this is where it starts to count. The Colts have a shot to win most of the meets that we're going to be competing in now, and at the top level, it's anyone's game. First, we have county relays, a meet that we won last year on the small school division, and a meet we have just as good a chance as anyone to win this year as well. Pole vault, how are you feeling?
We got a little prayer going. So, and if it don't feel good, what are you doing it for? 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 Hey, ho, here she go, either a little too high or a little too low. Self-esteem and vertigo, 'cause she thinks she's made of candy. Hey, ho, here she go, either a little too loud or a little too close. Got a hurricane in the back of her throat, she thinks she's made of candy. Hey, ho, here she go, either a little too high or a little too low. Got no self-esteem and vertigo, 'cause she thinks she's made of candy. Hey, ho, here she go, either a little too loud or a little too close. Got a hurricane in the back of her throat, she thinks she's made of candy.
Sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door, where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar. Come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down a garden gate. There's not much time left today.
Going
best part of the pizza is the cheese. Mm-hmm. By far away. The crust isn't bad, you know?
This is the road and these are the hands. Come on, same beats at those Memphis nights. The copper paths have been cool as ice.
How did it feel to lose county relays?
Not good. I was happy to break the 4x mile record and happy to sit on the L screens with my boys in the freezing cold and then, you know, get hyped with everybody on the infield. That was really fun.
It's like, honestly, like county relays is like one of my favorite meets of the year. And I remember it went pretty good. I was actually a little scared in county relays because I started to feel a little pain in my hip again. And I was, you know, based on last year, I was really, really paranoid.
Don't worry
but
about that.
That never got worse, so that was good. But performance-wise, Randolph was fine. That was where I ran my first, I think, 4x4 of the season, or 400. And that went good. And then county relays, I ran my first sub-50 split, so that was fun too. And yeah, they were just good experiences overall.
Losing the small school title at county relays definitely hurt, but it was something that we could come back from. The next meet on the calendar was the NJAC Small School Championship. Again, a meet that we were coming in having to defend our title from last year. With our team back at full strength, this was the week for us to do something special.
Wants to Way to close.
You said that we would always be. Without you, I feel lost at sea. Through the darkness, you'd hide with me. Like the wind, we'd be wild and free. You said you'd follow me anywhere. Through your eyes, tell me who won't be there.
We are getting second place today.
From myself and the truth I fear. My heart is beating, I can't see clear. How I'm wishing that you were here. You said you'd.
got a bug in my eye with like 3 laps left. It hurts so bad. But I did it.
Weight you got in there, Portman?
Like 110, I think.
It's gotta be new PR. New PR.
We are the champions. Really has a nice ring to it, doesn't it? How did conferences go?
Good. Just knowing you got to get your job done and then come out with the win was really exciting. And for a first team win in championship season was really good.
NJACs was fun. It went good. The 100 I didn't enjoy too much because I got third and I was kind of pissed about that because I lost to Clyde and Chris. So I remember crossing the line, I threw my headband out of anger. And I just remember the 400 was later that day and I remember thinking like, all right, I have to win this just for my own like sanity. And I did. I remember coming down the home stretch of like the 400. Matthew Griffin was like right on my hip and I remember thinking like, I swear to God, if this kid passes me, like I'm gonna be so pissed. But luckily that didn't happen. So the 400 went well. And then the 200 the next day also went pretty well. That was a really fun race. I lost to Chris by like a couple hundredths of a second, but it was fun. And yeah, I enjoyed that race a lot. After winning the NJAC title, the Colts were on a high. Championship season isn't just the best part of the season for the varsity team. It's the end and a celebration for everyone. The freshmen and the sophomores get their own competition at the Morris County Frosh Off Championships, where the best of the best of the future of track and field get to show what they got. To Madison for Frosh Off Championships.
We'll be right back.
Good. Fight, man. How's that last lap? Looked like a hard close.
Hard last lap. Finishing like 443, 444.
Top six though, so you're medaling.
Good race, yeah.
Light seat there.
Disappointed. You know, could have done better. Should have been more focused. I was a little distracted, you know. Just had a good start though. But
lock back in next race.
Hurdles, yeah. I'm locking in.
Locking in. We got a medal coming.
You know what? I'm waking myself up.
Kinnelon track does have a bright future. After the underclassmen were able to show what they had at the underclass county championships, the varsity team took to the Morris County Championships. It can feel difficult to get excited for this meet, as a small school like Kinnelon doesn't really have a chance at doing anything competitively. But it's still an important mark in our season. As the state meets afterward have entry limits of 3 competitors per event, this can be the last meet for a lot of our athletes. This can be their last chance to leave it all on the line and show what they have. So the end of your season and the end of your career came at counties.
Right.
How did that go?
Counties was, I don't know, it was bittersweet. So I'll give like a very, very quick overview of my career. I've ran for 12 seasons. I was injured my junior year. I had a really good shot to break 5 in the mile my sophomore year. Obviously that didn't happen because of COVID. Injured all throughout my junior year. Sort of came back in the winter and really, I guess, came back into shape in the spring. But obviously, because you guys are a really good distance group and our team is really strong, so I knew that like even if the next 10 guys got injured, I wasn't really gonna run at sectionals. So counties was my last hurrah, and the saddest thing is always wasted potential, and I don't think I really tapped into my potential. So just seeing that, it made me a little sad, but that's life, you know?
For the Morris County Championships at Booton, this is the time to give it your all. You're on the outside, right?
Yeah. Thank God. It's like the only reason, like, the outside is so easy. The inside is so hard.
Final words of wisdom for yourself?
Get it done quick.
Yeah. How you feeling? You're gonna run fast.
I feel great.
You got the wind at your back today, big PR season.
Currently my PR is a 12.7.
That's unacceptable.
I'm gonna run a sub 12, right?
Huge PR. Alright, show them who's boss. Nice job. Pirate. Johnny's after
your hairstyle. Just for Johnny. Just you're making me feel brand new. You're more than a sunshine in my eyes. La 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 la
Booten Hurdle Crew. Booten Hurdle Crew.
Thoughts on the mile, boys? Roz, last high school race?
450, sub 450. Last high school race, just gotta send it and just do it for the boys, you know? Gotta remember my teammates and just try as hard as I can. Have fun with it, you know?
Absolutely. Foreman?
Hopefully sub 450.
All right, love the shirt, love the shirt. Another shirt if you're on 440, I'll give you mine.
Anywhere at 440?
Nah, 440 point. Let's see.
But hopefully, maybe freshman record, 447, we'll see.
All right, let's see. Good luck. How we feel? We have.
Tough, man. Tough last race.
Persevered through it.
Yeah, you know, just a lot of my guys, you know, the guys that we work out with every day and I run with, and I thought, you know, how can I let them down? You know,
100%.
Five runs slow, it's like almost letting them down, so I just had to push for it and just remember my teammates.
It's a cult mentality. Cult
mentality.
Ready?
For what?
To throw a disc?
No, not at all.
No?
Oh, is this on video?
Yeah, it is. It's part of the documentary. Like that.
Ask me some questions.
You ready for disc?
Oh, I'm ready, all right.
Is this your first event of the day?
First event of the day? Well, see, I'm already competed. I'm already done because I won finals.
You're already done?
No, I'm not at all. I haven't won yet because I'm in the bottom of the bottom.
Okay.
I'm like in like the top.
That means you're going to surprise everyone,
I'm
right?
Maybe in the top 50 for the day. So okay. I'm not even going to finals because they're just that scared of me.
So, that's true. They need to nerf you, otherwise you'd destroy everyone, right?
Tell me, I mean, see, my thing is I always aim for the guys who measure, so I tell them to stand all the way up.
Gotcha. All right,
Last time I hit somebody's windshield.
If you take any heads off today, we'll, insurance will cover it.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Good luck.
Thank you.
How's the warm-up, Kyle?
It's good. Ready for the race. Sub 440, sub 430.
Used to pray for a moment just like this. There's a fire in your eyes, I can't resist. Baby, we're gonna wanna remember this. Baby, we're gonna wanna remember this. I can taste it forever on your lips. There's a lifetime living inside that kiss. Baby, we're gonna wanna remember this. Baby, we're gonna wanna remember this.
Just an interview?
Huh? Just want your thoughts.
Weird race, tough race, pretty good race.
Garcia, nice move there, the lap to go.
I felt like I should have gotten faster in the middle, but I tried to stick with the front pack and kick at the end, so I feel like I got a good place, but I could have gotten a better time.
Gotcha.
Used to pray for a moment just like this. There's a fire in your eyes, I can't resist. Baby, we're gonna wanna remember this. Baby, we're gonna wanna remember this. There's a lifetime living inside that kiss. Baby, we're gonna wanna remember this. Baby, we're gonna wanna remember this.
Life moves a little faster every second I'm with you. I didn't know what I was after until I found it all in you. This I know. If tonight is all we got, don't let go. Yeah, yeah. Just one more dance, two more drinks. It'll go by. There's a fire in your eyes, I can't resist. Baby, we're gonna wanna remember this. Baby, we're gonna wanna remember this. I can taste it forever on your lips. There's a lifetime living inside that kiss. Baby, we're gonna wanna.
Successful. Happy with third. Always room to improve, but we're happy with today, and we'll see what we can do in the 200 tomorrow.
Baby, we ain't gonna wanna remember this. You know it's true. Baby, we're gonna wanna remember.
Let's go, Gars. Let's go, Braeden.
Interview with Braeden Carroll. Interview with Braeden Carroll after the 205 comeback. How do we feel?
It's just awesome, man. It's like all of the hard times that these boys, that you, that coach, that everyone helped me get through. It's like you come back here, you exceed your expectations, you exceed everyone's expectations. It's like, it's just, it makes it all worth it, man.
The boys, Braeden Carroll, 205-15. I'm in Northern Michigan.
Intersection.
We're watching a great 2 mile right now.
About to watch Kyle dust that.
Kyle's gonna dust Big John C and he's gonna win the race. It's gonna be sub 11. She'll forget the way the moonlight shined upon her hair. And we were trying different things. And we were smoking funny things. Making love out by the lake to our favorite song. Sipping whiskey out the bottle. Not thinking about tomorrow.
You were really consistent. You were splitting like 117, 118.
I was trying to stay with that John kid.
Yeah.
From Dolby. I think I can place the sectionals if I really put in some good like long runs of training and all.
Yeah, no, I think you will. We were smoking funny things, making love out by the lake to our favorite song. Sipping whiskey out the bottle, not thinking about tomorrow. Singing Sweet Home Alabama all summer long.
I'm hungry and I need my wallet. Singing Sweet Home Alabama all summer.
Prelims went pretty well. See what we can do in the finals. I think seed is second right now, so see what we can do.
Change. Oh, how we thought those days would never end. Sometimes I hear that song and I'll start to sing along and think, man, I'd love to see that girl again. Man, I'd like to see that girl again. And we were trying different things, and we were smoking funny things, making love out by the lake to our favorite song.
I didn't warm up enough as
much as I should have. Like, I thought there was another heat of the 2 mile. Then I was up. Singing Sweet Home Alabama all summer long. Singing Sweet Home Alabama all summer long. Singing Sweet Home Alabama all summer long. Singing Sweet Home Alabama all summer long.
All right, so the next up was counties. How'd that go for you?
It went pretty well. It was definitely like more nerve-wracking than other meets just because, you know, you're going against kids that you don't normally go against. So for me, like in the 400, like Josh Babe, Jason Meza, they're really fast. And so I'd really be testing myself. And, you know, but I was able to run my race. I got, you know, a PR at the time. And then also in the 200, we had some scratches. So I was able to place higher in that too, which was pretty nice. But overall, I just enjoyed counties because like a lot of jokes like were made and like originated from that meet, like Raven and Mendy just being absolute bozos. It's like a lot of fun, so yeah.
Yeah. After counties, the season kicks into full gear. State sectionals is the beginning of the state tournament season. After winning the sectional titles in cross country and indoor track, a triple crown title was on the line, something that's rarely accomplished and Kinnelon has never done.
Obviously, big team goal was to win a sectional title. We've been talking about that for a very long time. I think the idea to win a sectional title really came into focus last year because we had a really good team. We were so, so close. And winning sectionals for cross, winning sectionals for indoor, it gave us this idea of like a triple crown, like, hey, we can do it. And we had a lot of good people return. We had a lot of new people come. So I guess winning a sectional title was the big team goal.
Goal for the team, win sectionals, and do as well as we could at groups.
This is the year, with the strongest team of athletes assembled in perhaps the entire history of Kinnelon High School, this is the time to accomplish what has seemed impossible for so long. State Sectionals, Clifton High School.
Just
just wants to know that you're well.
After party, we still going, going strong. Speed so fast, like a Ferrari. We get wild, like on safari. We still going, going strong. And all of these good things, good things, good things. All we need, good things, good things, good things. Till now we go all night long. We party like Post Malone. Don't tell me to go.
How you feel?
I feel flipping amazing.
Flipping amazing. I like that. Boom. Awesome.
Thank you.
So, how do you approach that last jump with like everything on the line and like two fouls and four fouls already? Like, what's going through your head?
I've been. Thank you so much. So, had the first two fouls by about this much. I just took it back to a point where I knew I'd get on the board, get a mark. Drove the knee up, flung it forward. I feel great. We got 22 for us. Can't ask for much.
Awesome stuff. So close, and yet so far. Second place at sectionals, only 4 points behind Emerson, who won. It hurts to be that close to something that we've dreamed of for so long, but I think it's important to reflect on the positives. Reflect on school records set in relays and individual events. Reflect on people putting their maximum effort onto the track, and the end of some seasons and the continuation of others. We had 25 athletes qualify for the group championships, and we were able to beat most of the teams we competed against. Though it's a difficult pill to swallow, I think we have to reflect positively on sectionals.
after all that was done, the next meetup, we start state championship season with sectionals. What were your goals for sectionals? Thoughts going in?
Sectionals, do as best as I can, help the team win.
Glad to hear that. And how did that go?
We didn't win, but it was close again.
That it was. Any, want to highlight your own performances? Highlight any other performances, how'd you think?
Definitely a hard meet for myself, but I was happy to see a lot of other people succeed and do what they had to do. I was happy that I scored at least, but definitely a hard meet, but happy I pulled through and pushed through the pain.
Yeah, I mean, very few distance runners can go into that meet running the 8, the mile, the 2 mile, and the 4x8, and then moving on to groups and scoring in all of them.
Definitely.
How do you do it?
Definitely hard, but you just gotta go in and do your job. Coach expects you to do what you gotta do, and that's what I tried to do.
And your team will be eternally grateful for that. The 4x8 did actually end up breaking the sectional record, only to get second, as per tight. Though, that'll change later. What was the goal going into sectionals?
Win it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How did that go?
We didn't get it. We didn't win it. But, we came close again, which it sucks to be so close yet so far. But individually, I did well. I won the 100, 400, and then second in the 200, 4x4. So overall, like personally, it was probably the best meet I had of my track career in high school. But yeah, it's always just like a lot of fun to be in that competition, even if you don't win. Like, it's always so close, and just like having that, like, you know, that competition is always just like so fun. And it's like really exclusive to sectionals. Like, there's never another meet that's like that, like, crazy. It was a lot of fun, and it was pretty emotional too, because last sectional meet with the class of 2022, that made me upset. But other than that, yeah, it was fun.
That leaves us with groups. This is a meet we probably even have a better chance at winning than we did last week, because we have that talent at the top level, and you only need about 45 points to win. We have a very good shot at winning a state title, something that Kinnelon has never done in track and field. So as we drive down the long 2 hours to Pensauken, let's keep our eyes set on a state title. Rings, baby.
Run it up, I think I did that enough. Yeah, and I ain't trying to be that guy, but I just really think it's that time.
We're low-key in the best spot.
Where are we at right now?
Pensauken.
And what are we doing here?
Winning states.
Yeah.
It's 2 a.m. and cold outside. Is it too late to come? Oh, I can't even sleep at night, cause
there are certain moments where silence falls on a track and you know what that means.
After coming close but not close enough to the sectional title, Kinnelon had their eyes locked on a group title, and you would be playing a very important role in that. So, how did groups go?
It was tough. Well, first of all, I was sick the whole week leading up to states, or groups, I should say. I was actually sick, like, the second day of sectionals, and then that carried on until, like, maybe, like, Thursday. And, like, Friday is when I only started to, like, really start to feel better. But I think I was still, like, pretty weakened by that, because I remember on Friday I was only supposed to run the 100, and after prelims, I felt weak. I didn't feel great. But I was like, I'll have to suck it up. So, finals roll around. I get a really bad start. I'm in third. I have to, like, try and play catch up. And then about 70 meters in, I feel a twinge in my hamstring.
and I thought it was a cramp at first, so I didn't really do anything. I was like, oh, whatever, I'll just have to keep running. And then when I crossed the line, I realized, like, it wasn't a cramp. It was, like, something that, you know, I actually damaged my leg.
Yeah.
That was heartbreaking because, you know, most of my events were the next day, and that's where we were going to really score our points. You know, I was favored to win the 400, couldn't run that. 200, I probably could have done well. Weren't going to run that. And then the 4x4 too. So, yeah, it was tough. It was a tough one. But it's also, like, really always fun to just hang out with the team, like, be in the hotel, go to Olive Garden, and, like, made a lot of memories. I can't be too
in that waist, it's like a koozie. Tell me why I play this game and keep losing. They don't even act this bougie in the movies, yeah. But I get it, yeah. I guess I'm a critic when you're starring. Don't get me started, baby, I'm barding. Even got a picture of you hanging in my office. Yes, girl, I'm a fan of your Instagram. So give me a chance and maybe unblock me, yeah.
25, 25, 7. Give you all my attention, baby, you're my obsession. Ooh, 25, 25, 7. I'll give you love and affection, baby, you're my obsession.
At our local Wawa.
What are you getting?
Talking.
What are you getting?
I'm getting a Haribo Happy Cola. I'm a happy guy.
Happy guy. For the second straight week, we come just a little bit short. It's disappointing, but that's what happens when you set lofty goals. Our track season was one of so many incredible moments, so many incredible experiences, so many friendships built and bonds created. If you could define a favorite moment of yours from this season, what would it be?
A favorite? That's hard. We've had a lot of good moments. We've had a lot of really good moments. I think that my personal favorite moment was probably 4x8 at groups. I think you guys ran really well. You guys knew that it would be really hard and that at the end of the day, it was just kind of had to come down to the better 800 runner. And I thought you guys prepared really well. I thought you guys executed your race really well. And the people that were there were really supportive. I remember Ryan, Bjorn, and all the parents were there. We all really rallied around you guys. And I thought you guys ran really, really well.
It isn't running. It's in the hotel room at States. All like every single guy, probably like 30 of us, not 30, like 20 of us in one hotel room, just like talking and like, you know, screwing around, just having fun, like
watching some basketball.
Yeah, I mean, because like that was like, you know, the last time you're really gonna like be with everyone, like just like having fun, because like, you know, everyone, a lot of people are leaving this year, and it was just like really awesome, just like have that last like time together. I think that was definitely the highlight, because like it was really funny too. Yeah. Like, I don't know, it's just like hilarious.
Coming up, the meet of champions, and then the end of our season, the Kinnelon track party, where everyone celebrates, smiles, laughs, and thinks about the great times we had this year.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Somerset, New Jersey, the site of this year's New Jersey State Interscholastic Athletic Association Meet of Champions, as we prepare for the gathering of the top performers from last week's group championships in the Garden State, and bringing them back this weekend for the Meet of Champions. Always something that everyone in New Jersey looks forward to wrap up.
Now when the sun come up, I'll be there to say what up in the morning. Brush my teeth, find that clip I've been looking for since last night. I feel so caught up in the bud, I float somehow in my bedroom. Turn around, see myself in the mirror, I guess I'm cool. And those happy thoughts in my head, I'm feeling like I'm Peter Pan. Minus the tights and the berries, happy to see how far I've come to the same place. It began my dreams, imagination, perfectly at peace. So I move along a bit higher. I'll be up a bit away, up a bit away, cause they gon' judge me anyway. So whatever, I'll be up a bit away, up a bit away, cause in the end they'll judge me anyway. So whatever. I learn, I see the dreams I made, so I'm cooler now. I can take care of my mom, I'm alone in Surrey, so sing along, little mama.
Eli Gately, Kinnelon High School 4x8 here at the Meet of Champs. How did you feel talking to the race?
So, like, we came in trying to break the school record of like 7:30. You know, obviously that didn't play out, a little win, you know, but we just ran a good leg. We got our secondary goal.
But you heard it here, folks. You heard it here from the Meet of Champions. Guys, talk me through that race. How'd you feel? How'd it go? Kyle Brewerson, Kyle, let's start with you. You led off.
Lead off was tough. Got out fast. The wind on the back stretch. Killer. Threw one lap. I just knew I had to punch that second lap. So I just punched that my way. 207, what are you going to do?
Yeah, right. And then you passed off to Matt. Matt, how was your leg?
Dude, it was crazy. I was going too fast like last time, so I just slowed down a bit. But passed a couple people. Crazy win, like Kyle said. But it was a good race.
Right. You passed off to Eli, right? Yeah, so Eli, let's talk about your leg here.
I was pretty excited to see Missouri get the lead for us. So after that, going into it, I was pretty hyped. I just knew I had to hold the lead. And seeing that I had a pretty big lead was exciting. I knew I was in good hands handing off to Braeden. So I just wanted to beat Hasbro Heights, and it turned out.
So Braeden, anchor leg here, bring it home for the Colts.
Eli put it right in my hand. I said, I don't even know where Hasbro Heights is. We're just doing that well. But time on the clock doesn't really matter. It's windy. All I can say is it was a fun way to end the season. No stress, you know, we just had a good time. And, like, no one else I'd rather do it with than these boys here.
You hear it here first, guys. Kinnelon High School 4x8 team and Meet of Champs.
I'll be up a bit away, up a bit away, cause they gon' judge me anyway. So, whatever. I'll be up a bit away, cause in the end they'll judge me anyway. So, whatever. Wake up, 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 wake up
And then how did MOCs go?
MOCs, great last meet in track and field for me, and real exciting just to have a final race with the boys and beat Hasbrook Heights.
The end of the 2022 spring track season means the end of a year, or for some of us, 4 years of the greatest chapter in our lives. Though we may look on this season as a disappointing one, having not accomplished all that we had hoped to on the track, it's important to realize how far we've come. For me, running cross country and track for the last 4 years has been the greatest decision of my life. So thank you for the times we had, the memories we made, the bus rides, the meets, the parties. This is truly the greatest chapter in my life, and there's no one I would rather have done it with. The memories we made here will last a lifetime, and I will never forget the times we had in KTrack 22. Thank you.
Thank you. in me, but put your hands up high. If you lift them up, you might just touch the sky. All the lonely people, put your hands up high. If you loosen up, you might just learn to fly. All the highs and the lows and the way it all goes, you can't let them keep you down. If you're lost, if you're broke, if you're stuck on the road, you can turn it all around. Cause we gotta trust in love, something that can't be touched. A feeling to lift us up, all in the name of love. All the broken people, put your hands up high. If you lift them up, you might just touch the sky. All the lonely people.
Here with Eli Gately. Name great in the red.
Let me try that again.
Just think about that.
Oh, no way!
It's my son.
Yeah.
Just get any final remarks you
have. Kyle, 4x mile thoughts.
These are thoughts.
Yeah. Old boys. What? Documentary footage, yeah,
yeah.
Baby.
Oh, is this on video?
Yeah, it is. It's part of the documentary. Like that?
Wait, it's documentary?
Yeah.
Oh, are we doing like one on the
I'm trying team? To interview you.
Oh, you can cut all this out, right?
How are you feeling? How are you feeling? Are you asleep?
That's in.
Comments?
Oh my goodness, the win, bro. Like, I swear, it's so windy out.
If I make this, we're winning 4x8
tomorrow. I got the air ball. Comments? Oh, damn,
you're sorry.
What you reaching for in there?
Oh, is this video?
Yeah.
Come on. Let's see.
Is that first?
What
did Babe run?
Oh,
Yes, sir.
Balls for sex? Oh, shit. I'm not allowed to say that.
So bad.